Hello everyone. In this video session, I am going to explain part 21 of Java for Testers series, that is using float data type in Java. Float is one of the data types in Java. The previous videos already covered different other data types like int, double, char, boolean, string non-primitive data type, then byte, short, long. Okay, all these data types I covered as part of the previous videos in the same series, and in the current video session I'm going to cover the next data type, that is float data type. So what is the purpose of float data type in Java? The purpose of the float data type in Java is to store the decimal values to the variable which is declared with float data type. If you declare a variable with float data type, then you can store decimal values into this float data type. Okay, a variable, you can store decimal values into the variable which is declared with this float data type. But guys, there is one difference here. Okay, so in Java you can use two different data types, like you can either use float data type or double data type. Okay, to store the decimal values, you can either use float data type or you can use double data type to store the decimal values into the variables. So what is the difference between the float and double? Float is, the difference here is size, guys. Okay, the size of the float data type is different from the size of the double data type. That is, double data type is two times bigger than float. That is the only difference between the float and double. Both into the variable which is declared with this float or double, we can store the decimal values. And coming to the float data type, okay, if you declare a variable with this float data type, then you can store decimal values, right? 3.69. If you give some 3.69 decimal value here, do you think this will work or not? This will not work, guys. This will give you the compiler error. The reason here is, in order to store decimal values into the variable which is declared with this float data type, you have to add a literal. Okay, that is either small f or capital F, you have to add at the end of the decimal value. Then only this decimal value will be stored into this variable which is declared with float data type. But coming to double, it's not required, guys. Okay, if you declare a variable A with the double data type, you can directly store the decimal values like this. Okay, there will not be any compiler error. But in case of float data type, okay, if you declare a variable with float data type, then you have to provide the decimal floating type, decimal literals only. Okay, in case of double, normal decimal literals are allowed. Literal values are allowed. Okay, here example is 3.69. It's a normal decimal value. Okay, decimal literal value. But in case of float, okay, in case of a variable which is declared with float data type, okay, here normal decimal literal values are not allowed. If you provide 3.69 to this variable which is declared with float, you will get a compiler error. Okay, you cannot provide like this. Instead, you have to provide floating type, okay, float type decimal values only. That is, after this decimal value, you have to add either small f or capital F, anything you feel, okay, like this. Then only it will be allowed to this variable which is declared with float data type. In case of double, guys, okay, in case of double, you can provide the normal decimal literal values. At same time, you can also provide decimal values with, okay, decimal value with decimal value of double type literals. Okay, here both are allowed, normal decimal literal values and decimal value of double type literals are also allowed. So normal will be like this, 3.69 is the normal decimal value, whereas double type decimal literal is, you have to simply add capital D or small d at the end of this number. Okay, here both these values are, okay, are allowed in case of the double data type. But coming to the float data type, you can only assign the float type decimal value literal. Okay, you cannot assign the normal decimal value literal in case of the float data type variable. Okay, I'll explain about the literals in detail in the upcoming videos, guys. Okay, there are different types of literals, guys. Not only this literals, but there are different literals in Java. I will be explaining about this literals in detail in the upcoming videos. For now, just understand that in order to store a decimal value to a variable which is declared with float data type, you have to assign only float type decimal values only. Okay, float type decimal value literals only can be assigned. If you assign normal literals, that will not be taken into consideration. Okay, you'll get compiler error. For example, here, let's create a variable A and declare that with float data type. Now try to assign the normal decimal value literal. Okay, like this. You see, you got immediately got a compiler error. Okay, so it's saying that by default this decimal value is of which type literal it is? By default it is of double type literal. Okay, even though you didn't provide D here. Okay, it is becoming a by default the decimal values will be double type literals, double type decimal values. That's the reason you cannot assign this double type literals to the variable which is declared with float data type. To convert this decimal value to the float floating point or float type or float type literals, you have to simply add capital F or small f at the end of this number. Okay, then it will become, this literal will become a float type decimal value literal, and you can assign to the variable of float data type. Okay, it's compulsory, guys. System.out.println. If I print A, the decimal value will be printed. You see, it's working fine. And one more thing, guys. So let's find out the range, okay, of this floating point literal. Okay, floating float type decimal value literal. Okay, I will keep on adding the number here. You see, I got a error, compiler error. I got the literal, whatever the literal value gave, and you mentioned it as which type, float type. You mentioned of type float is out of range. Okay, it is already out of range. That's why this number cannot be stored into the variable which is declared with float, because this literal is out of range, guys. Okay, it's not allowed. Okay, the size is more than what is expected. Now if you convert this F to D, okay, in place of F, if I place D, okay, what will happen? Let's find out. Over the mouse, okay, cannot convert from double to float. Okay, so if this is double, now if I add D here instead of F, if I add D here, this will become a double type decimal value literal. Okay, so I have to change the data type to double. You see, it's working. Now if I print, it will work. You see, it's working. Okay, it's working. So this is how, guys, we have to understand the literals and data, different data types in Java, and which literals you can assign to the which data types, and what is the range of literals that you can assign to the variables declared with that, such kind of data types. Everything we should know. Okay, so for now, the size difference between this float and double is, the size of the float data type is 2 times smaller than the double data type. Here I mentioned that double is 2 times bigger than the float. That is, for your knowledge purpose, you don't have to even remember this. The size of the float data type is 32-bit single precision, 32-bit IEEE 754 floating point. Whereas the size of the double data type is double precision, 64-bit IEEE 754 floating point. Okay. So, and in practical, this is the case, guys. Okay. The practical, this is the case. So for assigning a decimal value to the floating point, float type or data type variable, we have to add F letter at the end of the decimal value to make it a float type decimal value. Okay, only float type decimal values are allowed in case of float data type. Normal decimal value is nothing but a double data type by default, guys. Okay, double decimal value by default. So even you here, guys, in case of this decimal value, even though you provide D or you don't provide D here, by default it is double type decimal value. Okay, that's the reason here float data type variable is not allowing you to assign the double type decimal value literal. Okay, this 3.69 is a double type decimal value literal. That's why it's not allowed. So you have to specifically add or compulsorily add F at the end of this decimal value to make convert into a float type decimal value literal. Okay, then it will allow you. And if it is out of range, you have to, okay, you have to change the data type to double so that it can store the out of range float type. Okay, and you have to convert that float type decimal value literal to the double type decimal value literal. Fine. So, and what else? So that's it, guys. This is how we have to use float data type in Java. And one more thing before I conclude is like, in general, guys, in general Java programming or in general test automation, whatever it is, when you try to store some decimal value into a variable, you generally use which data type? You generally use double data type only. In real time, we use double data type, guys, for storing the decimal values. Until and unless there is a requirement, okay, there is a memory requirement. Until and unless there is a memory constraint or something that is there in your project. Otherwise, okay, everyone in common, everyone use by default double data type for storing the decimal values into a variable. Okay, for storing the decimal values into the variable, everyone will be using double data type. Okay, float is only required when there is a real requirement of memory problem management or something in your project. Okay, otherwise, in 99%, everyone will be using double data type in their projects for storing the decimal values. So that's it, guys. In the next video session, I'll practically demonstrate passing decimal values to the int data type declared variables. Okay, passing the decimal values to the int data type declared variables. So that's it, guys. See you in the next video session. Thank you. Bye.